Hey there, everybody, and welcome to the channel. I'm your host, Pooborama, and in today's video, I'll be reviewing the Comet SR. This is one of the best vehicles that Rockstar, unfortunately, removed from the game. However, the good news is that this week, up until Thursday, you can get your hands on the vehicle. It's very easy to get. All you need to do is go over to the LS Carmi and purchase the vehicle for $1.1 million. Just like that, I've got one of these being delivered to my garage. In today's video, I'm going to be showcasing all the customization this vehicle features, and I'm going to be showcasing why it's a fantastic vehicle to get your hands on when it comes to lap time and top speed. Let's get straight into it. And here she is, the Comet SR. Let's see what upgrades we have going for us. Obviously, we're going to do the basic ones like armor and the brakes, but now we have a couple bumper options. Not a lot, to be fair. I'm just going to do the competition splitter because I think that one looks the best. We got a rear bumper option as well, which doesn't really seem to do anything. I think I'm just going to stick with the carbon for now, and depending on what color we make the vehicle, I'll figure out if I want to change that. We got some changes here for the side. We got some primary intakes and some secondary intakes. We're gonna go for stock again. I think the carbon honestly looks really good, so we'll leave it like that. We got some engine upgrades. Okay, titanium tipped exhaust. We got oval exhaust. I do not like those oval exhausts. We're gonna go with titanium. I always like that little blue hint it has going for it. We got fenders, which, yeah, there's a bit of an extended arch. Cool, looks fine. We got some hood options, which doesn't really change the hood all that much. Some lights. Arriving at the most important upgrade of them all, we have the color. Now, I already own one that is black, and I actually think it looks really, really nice like this, but because I already have one with a blackish color, I'm gonna go for a different color. Honestly, I think this garnet red looks really nice. I'm gonna put that on the vehicle for now, but also the sunset red. Ooh, there's some really good options for this vehicle. I think Porsches look really good with so many different color options. They look great in greens, they look great in blues, they look honestly good with a lot of different colors. It's not like a lot of other car manufacturers where, like, they look good with specific colors. After scrolling through a lot of the colors, I think I'm gonna stick with the sunset red. It just looks really nice on this vehicle. It's a little discreet yet pretty popping, and I just think it looks great, so that's what I'm gonna stick with. We got some roof options. I'm gonna go with just primary. I don't love carbon most of the time. I think it looks better primary. We got some skirts that we can do. I'm gonna go for carbon for that. I think that actually looks nice there. Now we got our spoiler options. Now, while this vehicle may not have a lot of upgrades on the bumpers or, you know, most of the parts, what I will say is that when it comes to spoiler options, this vehicle actually has a decent chunk, and the fully upgraded spoiler looks really dang nice. So I can either go for a carbon spoiler or a primary race spoiler, a secondary. There's a lot of good options here. I think I'm gonna go for the secondary for now. I made it a matte red, but like a dark red, that way it just kind of reflects off the main color we have. So I think that looks pretty nice. We got some suspension. Obviously, we're going to lower that transmission and finish it off with a turbo. Let's make our way over to the wheels. As usual, going to do the wheels I put on basically every car. And there you have it. Okay, well, the vehicle is fully upgraded. Let's bring it outside and see how it looks. I'm actually really glad I picked this color. I think it looks absolutely amazing when the sun is shining on it. The way that it's not too vibrant that it's like, look at me, I'm in your face, but it's also bright enough that it pops when the sun is shining on it. So this has got to be one of actually my nicer looking vehicles I think I've done a paint job in a while on. Let me know what you guys think about it in the comments down below. But the paint job aside, I actually think the vehicle looks really nice in general. It's a Porsche, and Porsches are always really nice vehicles. They're kind of sleeper cars. They don't look like they're going to blow the doors off a super until you actually realize they are really fast. I just think that this car in general looks really nice, the way that it's got extended rear wheel arches, the way that the front is super sporty, the intakes. I'm just a big fan of this vehicle in general. So now that we've done all the customization and you've seen what this car has to offer, let's talk about its performance. We start off with this vehicle's top speed, being 122 miles per hour. That's actually pretty fast. It places it in the 28th position out of 102 sports cars available in the game. It's not amazingly fast, but it's definitely fast enough to keep up with the top of the pack. Not only does it have a decent chunk of speed going for it, but it also features the 10th best lap time out of all of the sports vehicles available in the game, including HSW. That is really impressive. If you're on PC like me, then it's even higher up on the list because there aren't HSW vehicles available. So yeah, the Comet SR, quite an impressive vehicle when it comes to its capabilities and performance. Definitely worth the only $1.1 million it's costing right now. To showcase the Comet SR's superb handling, we're going to be doing this week's time trial, which is Casino. This time trial is actually perfect for today's video because of the fact it's got so many sharp corners and bends that we're going to have to traverse through to finish it. Now, I don't know if we're going to beat the par time, but what I'm going to do is we're going to see how fast the Comet SR can complete this time trial, and then we're going to pull out a vehicle like the Ocelot Pariah and see how it compares, because the Ocelot Pariah is obviously known for speed and not nearly the handling. So we're going to speed on through here, we're going to slow down around this corner, and nice! I thought we were going to hit that car, but we just ever so slightly were able to get around it. Now we're going to hug this corner tight. Okay, pretty good so far. There's a lot of cars on the road right now, which is something that I obviously have to be quite careful about. Don't want to crash into anybody. Let's take this corner wide. There you go. Nice. All right. Hug the corner here. Doing pretty good so far. We got about 40 seconds down, and we're just rolling around the corner. We're going to have to take this one wide, though. That's the only thing I don't love about time trials. I think they should make it like Forza. When you're in some sort of time trial or event, you can't drive into streetcars because it would make it so much more enjoyable. So we're going to roll around this corner here. Nice. Okay. We're not going to complete the time trial, but pretty dang close. I kind of messed this up here at the end, so yeah, we'll subtract a teeny bit of time off. We'll say I completed this in about 1 minute, 2 seconds. I can't believe I took the wrong corner there at the end. But I'm going to go pull out the Ocelot Pariah, and we'll see how it compares. All right, let's get the Pariah lined up and see how it does. 3, 2, 1, speed is key. We got 1.5 miles and 1 minute on the clock. I don't think we're going to beat it, but I do think we're going to get fairly close to what we saw with the SR for the overall lap. All right, let's use that speed, or at least a bit of that speed, to accelerate and gain a bit of time. Let's slow down so we can roll around this corner here. Nice. Okay, keep on going. And let's roll around this corner here, slow down a bit. Oh, you can see the handling already on the Pariah trying to give out there a bit. It's not nearly as well-mannered when it comes to taking these corners. We're gonna do the exact same thing here, keep going wide, slow down a bit. Bro, really? Really? Okay. Attempt number 2. Hopefully a car will not drive in front of me that I literally can't do anything to block. That's one of the only downsides of the time trials, as I said just a moment ago with the SR, is that you have to deal with street cars, which can affect your lap time quite a bit. So, a bit unfortunate. But so far, we're doing okay. We're getting back up to the hilly part, which is the most dangerous bit. Oh man, you can see every time we go around that corner there, it just loses a bit of grip and tries to spin out. Thankfully, we're able to save it, but yeah, not gonna be great for the lap time, I'm guessing. All right, let's keep going here. Hopefully no cars try to turn in front of us. Okay, all good. Let's keep going, keep going. Use that acceleration. All right, we gotta slow down now so we can roll around this corner. Okay, just like so. We got 0.4 miles to go, and we're about 50 seconds on the clock. So I actually have no clue how this is comparing to the SR, but I think it's pretty on point, actually. All right, let's slow down a bit. Let's roll around this corner, and let's take it correctly this time. And done. Okay, so 1 minute and 3 seconds, and we actually did this one pretty well. Compare that to the 1 minute and 2-ish, 3 seconds I said for the SR, because we messed up the ending bit, and yeah, I'd say that these vehicles performed pretty dang similar. But that just showcases how good the Comet SR is on its handling. That is just so impressive, because the Pariah is known for ridiculous speed, and we're able to use that speed and acceleration to obviously keep up with the SR. But the fact that a vehicle much slower is still able to give this vehicle a run for its money just by its handling, it showcases that, in reality, lap time is usually one of the more important values rather than speed, unless you're planning on driving down a super long stretch of road. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Comet SR, an absolutely amazing vehicle when it comes to looks, and an absolutely fantastic car when it comes to handling and top speed. If you enjoyed today's video, let me know, and don't forget to click that like button and subscribe button. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.